One of my favorite aspects of games is the wide range of emotions and moods they can convey. If a game has a unique atmosphere and good writing, I'm probably going to enjoy it to some extent. I like action and strategy as much as the next nerd, but sometimes all I need is a good narrative with soothing visuals and music. In other words, something like Ihatovo Monogatari. Released in 1993 for the Super Famicom, Ihatovo Monogatari, or Stories of Ihatovo, is a classic adventure game that was never formally released outside of Japan. It was given an unofficial translation patch in late 2018, and thank God for that. Otherwise, I never would have experienced one of my favorite SNES games. For those who don't know, the SNES has one of my favorite libraries of any console, right up there with PlayStation 1 and 2, so I was really impressed with this little gem. There's not much in the way of complex gameplay here, but what is here is a charming, contemplative story, full of life lessons and emotional moments. If I had to sum up Ihatovo in one word, it would be comfort. Somewhat bittersweet comfort. It's a game that understands the hardships of life, that no one is perfect, and that people aren't defined by their mistakes. It's a story with no real villains, just folk who have done wrong and aim to make amends. It's a soothing experience from start to finish. So, let's dive in and start analyzing what makes it so special. Booting up the game provides you with a quote. "Let us suppose that the phenomenon known as oneself is a blue light that gleams from an organic illumination. It flickers busily about, with the scenery and everyone else around. Indeed, the light keeps on burning. 'Tis a blue light, the illumination of cause and effect." This is a game about life, and how each life is able to affect and be affected by all other lives. Opening with a quote like this helps to establish the theming of the game, and gets the player in a contemplative mood. It's a simple trick, hardly unique to Ihatovo, but it's a good way to get the audience in the right headspace. The opening features a beautiful track, equal parts mysterious and inviting. I love the big, full sound of that Super Nintendo sound chip. We see a train cutting a path through a mountainous forest before arriving at the small town of Ihatovo. We're a traveler who's been wandering around the world with no particular destination. We decided to get off at this station simply because the name of the town sounded like something out of a fairy tale. We begin our low-key adventure and start exploring the town. Yeah, that's right. No tragic backstory, no clash of good and evil, just a traveler on a journey with no destination in mind. Life is about the journey, after all. As we head into town, we talk to folks to gather information and quickly learn about the big players in the neighborhood. We learn about Kenji Miyazawa, a local poet and storyteller who's apparently the pride of the city. He's away on business, and apparently he's lost 7 journals of his writing a while back. Seemingly just out of the goodness of our heart, we decide to search around and try to find these journals for him. And in doing so, we end up helping all the people and animals we meet. This is the meat of the game. You walk around having interesting conversations with memorable characters, watching as touching tales and somber backstories unfold around you. There's some basic adventure game style puzzles, no combat, no platforming, just a lot of walking around and talking. And I kinda love it. I admire the fact that the game is confident enough in its core appeal that it doesn't feel the need to add much in the way of gimmicks. The first story centers around an artifact called the Shellfire, which lets the holder speak to any animal. We learn that most humans have lost their ability to talk with and understand animals, implying a loss in connection with nature over time. The game is brimming with moments of solemn implication like this. While looking for the Shellfire, we meet with Professor Ursus, an animal capable of human speech. He initially keeps us at arm's length, saying he'll only help us if we bring him a gift. We go and talk to people around town until someone mentions the professor likes poetry. So, we ask a local poet to give us a poetry book for the professor. This is how the game generally flows. It's like a point-and-click adventure with RPG-style interface. You have an inventory, you talk to people, you rub objects against other objects to get results. Pretty simple. The game relies on its charming presentation and writing to stay engaging, and it works really well. It's probably not everyone's cup of tea, but it's enough for me at least. Getting back to that first story, we learned that the Shellfire is meant to be held by the leader of all animals. Once upon a time, there lived a kind and brave rabbit called Homoy. He once saved a pair of skylarks from drowning in the river. the king of the Skylarks felt he was worthy of the Shellfire and gifted it to him. Although Hamoy was apprehensive at first, he eventually came to enjoy his role and even be proud of it. One day, a gray fox came to serve Hamoy, but he didn't have his best interests at heart. The fox flattered the rabbit and stroked his ego, until eventually Hamoy thought he and the fox could do no wrong. One day, the fox captured two birds in a glass cage, and the rabbit looked the other way. It turned out these birds were the same pair that had given him the Shellfire all that time ago. Even as they begged for help, Hamoy ignored their plea, not wanting to cross the fox he had come to trust. The Shellfire began to lose its luster, reflecting the cloudy judgment of its owner. If you'd like to avoid spoilers for how this story ends, skip to the time shown on screen. Homoy's father gave him a stern lecture, and the pair teamed up to chase away the fox and free the Skylarks. But when the pair returned home, they saw the Shellfire had lost all its light. It was too late. The gem suddenly erupted into shards, scattering in all directions and piercing Homoy's eyes, turning them white and clouded. He was never able to see again. If you place the Shellfire near the grave of Hamoy, his spirit appears before you. He warns you not to make the same mistakes he did, claiming that he exists in this sorry state due to having a prideful heart. He advises us not to fall into the snare of our own emotions, and silently fades away. With that, we set down the path and return to the city of Ihatovo. A pretty somber, contemplative story. Other stories in the game are comical, heartwarming, or similarly tragic, but they all share one common trait. They invite contemplation and introspection. It's a moody game that takes itself pretty seriously. Even its comedic moments tend to have a lesson to teach. Another overarching theme in the game is the appreciation of art. The most celebrated resident of the town is a writer. One of the best tip givers is a singer. There's a cinema in the town that actually plays a Charlie Chaplin flick, which is a pretty cool reference. Stuff like that. It's a nice theme, and as a creator who's interested in many different mediums, I like how much the devs clearly admired multiple different art forms. Which is the perfect transition into me gushing about this game's incredible music. Y'all, just listen to this. This is the main theme for Ihatovo City, and it melts my heart into mush. It's hard for me to convey just how this track makes me feel. It has these tinges of nostalgia and fills me with a profound sense of peace. I particularly love this quiet guitar section. It contrasts nicely with the sweeping string sections. It's a song that transitions smoothly between relaxing vibes and big dramatic emotion, much like the game itself, and it's not the only standout track. The theme of the animal's forest stands out as truly bittersweet, which is appropriate given that this is where Hamoy's story takes place. It's a good track on its own, but the context of the story attached to it makes it heartbreaking in a really potent way. It's a powerful piece of music in a powerful OST. The music can be really dynamic as well. There's a village that starts with a solemn theme to reflect the sadness of the current situation, but it shifts into a more joyful, comforting version after you help one of the locals find something valuable to them. This small kindness improves the whole town, and this is reflected in the soundtrack. Overall, the music is a major highlight and really brings the game's emotional storytelling together. So, that's it, right? Game's perfect, no problems? Yeah, have you met me? And have you ever played an adventure game? Because Ihatovo Monogatari isn't immune to the common pitfalls of the genre. For one thing, it would be nice if NPCs gave some kind of indication that they had more to say, like have a little text balloon above their head or something. There are also times when the game expects you to talk to basically everyone in an area multiple times, and if you miss anyone, it'll halt your progress. Common problems in the adventure genre, but annoying nonetheless. There's also two specific characters that give you a lot of tips for when you're stuck. Leo at the town hall, and the stove cat at the cat office. You know, the cat office that every town has, where cute cats give you advice on the current objective of your life. That place. It's a good thing that these characters exist, but half the time, they're the only way you can figure out what the hell you have to do next. It makes things a little repetitive that you always have to go to these places. It's hard or even impossible to figure out what to do next without frequently consulting these characters. It's not that big a deal, but the game would flow better if your objective was more clear more often. Beyond that, yeah, I got next to nothing to complain about. Ihatovo Monogatari is a special little gem. It has one of the most emotionally engaging stories on the console, and generally feels ahead of its time. Narrative games are some of my favorites, and it was nice to play one from such a bygone era. The game's ROM is available in English at places you can probably find on your own. You know how the internet works, I believe you can figure this out on your own. This game is a new favorite, and I hope you have a good time with it. It's the kind of story that makes you contemplate life and feel grateful for what you have, and the lessons you've learned. I won't spoil how bittersweet the game is, but rest assured, you're in for an emotional ride. Thanks, as always, for watching. If you enjoyed this video, feel free to like, subscribe, and share it around the interwebs. I go live on Twitch pretty frequently these days, so feel free to hang out with me over there. I stream all sorts of games from all eras. If you want to support my work, Patreon and the direct donation link are still the best ways to do so. You can find that stuff below. Thanks so much to my patrons for keeping this channel, and me, alive. Until next time, stay safe out there, nerds.